We have found new ways to weaponize curiosity, pathways into the darkness. Warrior scholars of the light, warlocks devote themselves to understanding the traveler and its power. A warlock's mind is an arsenal of deadly secrets, balanced between godhood and madness. And on the battlefield, those secrets can shatter reality itself. Hey guys, this is Spectrum Tween, back with another subclass rework. Today we're going to be looking at the warlock's classic subclass, the Voidwalker. Before I jump into the rework though, we're going to be taking just a quick overview as to my terminology that I use in these videos once again. First up we have the subclass core, which is this main block, which consists of your super ability, your melee ability, your grenade abilities, your tactical abilities, and your movement options. This makes up your levels 1 through to 10 progression. On the other side we have your subclass augments, which act as your skill trees, which hone in on a certain or a particular playstyle. Augments have 6 perks to choose from. Players will choose 4. Firstly, if hunters are the bulk of the DPS and titans are the tanks, then warlocks can take on the mantle as both caster and support, manifesting their master of the light as devastating waves of power or helpful buffs for their allies. In these reworks, like replacing Defender with Sentinel, Sunsinger has evolved into Dawnbringer. Naming conventions are important, Bungie. That's why I've changed it from Dawnblade to Dawnbringer. Fireborn was a problematic and crutch-like perk available to warlocks, making them mandatory in most PvE scenarios, and even PvP for trials. But I also didn't want to completely strip away what Sunsinger did have to offer if they elected not to choose Fireborn, e.g. Song of Flame. Voidwalker sustain and lifesteal builds were often considered by players as the most fun build in Destiny, and I want to retain some of that in my rework. Stormcaller alongside Nightstalker and Sunbreaker receives very little changes due to being a TTK subclass and fucking awesome. In addition, all warlock subclasses now have access to Blink, the reason being that hunters have an inherent bonus agility and dodging, titans can skate, and warlocks can tear holes in space and time. The warlock tactical ability is the warlock's rift, allowing warlocks to conjure a well of light at their location to empower themselves and their allies. Each of the subclass has a new take on the warlock's rift. Let's jump into the Voidwalker. Those who have stared into the void are not bound by the laws of space and time. As I mentioned before, Voidwalkers are often said to be the most fun subclass to play because you throw out your scatter grenades and you proc lifesteal, you proc energy drain, you proc all kinds of fun stuff. I don't want to take any of that away from Voidwalkers, and in fact I want to refocus into two main areas. Big ass explosions and lifesteal and sustain. I actually enjoyed a lot of the perks that they gave us in the Destiny 2 beta, so I'll be taking some of those as some of the inspiration for my subclass rework of Voidwalker. So first up we have Nova Bomb, which is hurling an explosive bolt of void light at the enemy, and it disintegrates those caught within the blast. That explosive bolt will function like it will inherently function like it does in Destiny 1 when you hit level 4 and get your super ability for the first time. Your movement ability is obviously Glide. You have Burst Glide, Strafe Glide, and Blink. Those will be your movement nodes across all of your subclasses. Your grenade options for Voidwalker are the same as we see in Destiny 1 and 2, Vortex Grenade, Axiom Bolt, and Scatter Grenade. Your melee ability is Energy Drain, exactly how it functions in Destiny 1. Now your class abilities, your tactical abilities, Warlock's Rift, conjure a well of light at your location. Each well of light has a different effect depending on what subclass you are, what options you want to choose. So, for Voidwalkers, the first one I've given you is Chaotic Rift. Conjure a well of light that causes ally kills to explode in void light, so basically giving bloom to your allies. And there's a bit of synergy with that later on. Your other rift is Consuming Rift. Conjure a well of light that causes instant health regeneration on kills for yourself and allies. So it's kind of like Healing Rift, but it's much more of a lifesteal, killing-focused tree. Voidwalkers, I want you to be your boss damage dealers, but you got a little bit of clearing potential with it. Your first subclass augment is Attunement of Chaos, which is the Mr. Torque tree. It's your explosive focus tree. Your first perk is Soul Rip. Damaging an enemy with energy drain reduces the cooldown of Nova Bomb. Basically, you want to Nova Bomb a lot. Perk number 2 is Annihilate. Increase the size of explosions created by Nova Bomb and your grenades. This also synergizes with a perk later on. Perk number 3 is Angry Magic. Multiple kills with Nova Bomb immediately recharge your melee and grenade abilities. Maybe OP, maybe not. Synergy and cooldowns. Perk number 4 is a perk I borrowed from Destiny 2, Chaotic Accelerant. Yes, I did alter the name just slightly. Hold L1 or LB to draw power from your super to overcharge your grenade, making it deadlier and more effective. Perk number 5 is Bloom. This synergizes with Annihilate, it synergizes with Angry Magic. Your Void ability kills trigger explosions. Bloom also triggers on itself, so if a Bloom explosion causes someone else to explode, well then you can chain explosions for days. Someone get Mr. Torgan here because he would love this tree. And finally, your last perk is Cataclysm. Nova Bomb travels slowly, but seeks enemies out with Axiom Bolts. Fire at the Nova Bomb to detonate it. I think Cataclysm has a lot, as we see it in Destiny 2, has a lot of potential. I think it's just a case of finding that potential. That's why I'm keeping it here in my Attunement of Chaos. Moving on to subclass Augment 2, which is the Attunement of Hunger, which is your lifesteal focus tree. Perk number 1 is Devour. Killing an enemy with energy drain immediately regenerates your health. For a short time afterward, kills restore additional health. So exactly as it works in Destiny 2. Perk number 2 is Vortex. Nova Bomb creates a vortex which continually damages enemies in sight. Perk number 3 is Insatiable. Whilst the Devour effect is active, killing enemies extends its duration and recharges your grenade. So you're starting to see some synergies there. Perk number 4 is Feed the Void, another one I borrowed from Destiny 2 because I thought it was a really cool perk. Hold L1 or LB to consume your grenade energy and regenerate your health. This also grants you Devour. You're going to start to see more and more Devour synergy within this tree. Perk number 5 is Embrace the Void. Kills with grenades and Nova Bomb trigger the Devour effect, just like how we saw in Destiny 1 where your Void ability kills would trigger Lifesteal eventually. And finally, in the Attunement of Hunger is Vortex Mastery. Increase the range and duration of grenade and Nova Bomb effects. Basically, it's all about triggering your Devour and then having it last for an entire engagement, or at least getting it to last as long as possible. Anyway guys, that brings us to the end of my Voidwalker subclass rework. Quite a bit quicker than our usual ones. For me, the Warlocks were almost the easiest ones to redesign because their actual feel is pretty simple to grasp. And the playstyle is pretty simple to grasp and therefore is pretty easy to define and design. And I think Bungie honestly did a really good job in terms of designing the Warlocks with very, very set goals in mind. I feel like they struggled a little bit when designing the Hunter. But that's just me. Anyway guys, let me know what your thoughts are in the comments below. Subs and likes are appreciated, they do help us out. And I will see you next time, where we're going to be taking a look at the new subclasses we're going to be seeing in Destiny 2. But it's going to be my take on it. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace.